It's for the mayor of Niagara Falls. On the ballot, Democrat Robert Restaino. If he wins, he'll face off with Republican candidate Glenn Chukwokian in November. 7 Eyewitness News reporter Allie Toohey introduces us to the candidates who are ready to take over for Paul Dyster.
Voters were ready and waiting to cast their ballots when polls opened at Maple Avenue School in Niagara Falls Tuesday.
Yes, ma'am.
Chief among them, Democratic mayoral candidate Robert Restaino.
It's time for a change.
The 59-year-old is born and raised here in the Cataract City. The attorney and former city court judge says he understands the city has its challenges and he knows how to fix them.
Tackling poverty is the centerpiece of my campaign. To do that, you have to grow jobs.
Hi, is this John?
Seth Piccarello spent the morning calling voters and reminding them to vote. The 37-year-old father of two currently works for the city as the community development director. But he has his own ideas if elected mayor. He vows to cut taxes while investing in neighborhoods and establishing community policing.
To making sure that there's a connection between police officers that work a beat and the neighborhoods. Creating an opportunity for police to interact before the caution tape goes up.
As for the ongoing saga with the Seneca Niagara Casino over whether the Seneca Nation owes the state millions in revenue, both say they intend to reach out to the Senecas directly if elected.
We as local leaders should take it upon ourselves to talk directly to the Seneca.
When you fail to have a conversation, when you don't engage, nothing can get solved.
Democrats have about a 3-to-1 advantage over registered Republicans here in Niagara Falls. Still, the winner of today's primary will go on to face Republican candidate Glenn Chukwokian in November's general election. Reporting in Niagara Falls, Allie Toohey, 7 Eyewitness News.